An astronomer records an unusual radio signal from beyond our solar system.
Boom, 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 like a heartbeat from space.
It's so regular, it surely can't be anything natural.
Could this extraterrestrial signal be proof of intelligent life?
Something is sending a message back towards Earth.
November 28, 1967, Cambridge, England. Jocelyn Bell is an astronomy student examining radio wave data from the most sensitive telescope of its kind.
Jocelyn Bell is looking for quasars, objects that are 100 times brighter than the Milky Way.
She analyzes the 100 feet of radio wave data generated every night.
And it's just all on chart paper. I mean, miles and miles of chart paper. That's the way they did it back then. And she's going through and looking for, you know, radio sources.
What they're expecting to see is radio emission in continuous but somewhat random bursts.
Instead, something else grabs her attention. It's a regular pulse.
What she sees is a signal spaced precisely 1 1/3 seconds apart.
It's very regular, like a clock, better than any clock, in fact, that we could build.
This is beyond weird.
Bell shares the data with her supervisor, Anthony Hewish. The mysterious repetitive pulse is like nothing he's seen before. But he does notice a pattern.
The pulses are so precise, they cannot be coming from any natural phenomena. So it makes sense to ask, is this from man-made interference? The most likely source would be their own equipment.
To rule out equipment failure, Hewish asks another telescope team to see if they can detect the pulse.
And they find the same signal. So it rules out man-made interference.
The only answer was it was actually coming from outer space.
Bell suggests a controversial explanation.
She calls it a signal from Little Green Men, LGM. It's so unnatural, it's almost like it could be from aliens deliberately trying to send us a signal.
She finds something that could be the greatest discovery of all time, namely the existence of intelligence elsewhere in the galaxy.
Bell and Hewish dig deeper into their data to pinpoint the origin of the mysterious pulse.
They figure out the source is coming from a specific place in the sky, in a constellation, Vulpecula, and the source is about 200 light years away.
Vulpecula is home to 5 stars with orbiting exoplanets. Recent research reveals one of these planets even contains water, and water can mean life. Bell runs a more detailed analysis of her data.
She begins searching elsewhere in space for these odd pulses. And lo and behold, she finds one.
It's another pulsing signal, this time on a different frequency, but transmitting exactly the same way. Then she finds another, and another.
Now this tells her it's odd. There aren't multiple alien civilizations trying to communicate with us at the very same time using the very same method. She realizes this must be something else.
The mysterious pulse is not from Little Green Men, but from something just as incredible. Jocelyn Bell's LGM-1 signal comes from a new cosmological phenomenon. In February 1968, Bell and Hewish publish the discovery of a super-dense, highly magnetized celestial body. A neutron star.
What happens when a giant star dies is it collapses. And it collapses down into a neutron star. So dense, a sugar cube piece this big would weigh more than 10,000 aircraft carriers.
And it's spinning very fast, and because it has these strong magnetic fields, it's sending out beams of radio energy and also light into space.
It's giving off very powerful jets, only in two directions.
As the star is rotating, the signal, if it's pointing towards us, can be detected. It's kind of like a lighthouse. So as the lighthouse spins, you see the light, you see the light.
The pulsating neutron star responsible for the LGM-1 signal gets the nickname Pulsar.
The theory that Anthony Hewish presents to the astronomical world turns it upside down, and in fact, brings him the Nobel Prize for one of the greatest discoveries made.
The discovery lays the foundations of a pathway through the cosmos. Because pulsars are more than just another type of star, they are beacons for galactic navigation.
As we've begun to map the universe, we've now discovered over 1,000 of these pulsars.
Any intelligent species will know about all the pulsars in the neighborhood, so you can put them on spacecraft as kind of markers on a map.
The NASA teams behind the Voyager and Pioneer missions include maps of the pulsars nearest our planet. If intelligent life intercepts these deep space probes, they'll have a clear map to us on Earth. Whether it's a good thing to be advertising our location is uncertain.